there, it was Golu. Why did the demons want him? Creature summoned a dark mandala, a portal to another place. Raji rushed to stop them. But the demon chieftain blocked her path. And suddenly Golu was gone.
Where did you take him?
The demon defeated, the children rushed to thank Raji. But the stone had been weakened by the dark mandala. Perhaps Raji was about to die. Perhaps she had failed. And then the mystics came. They took Raji's body and they carried it away. As Raji drifted, a vision came to her. Who was that with her brother? What did they want? She awoke on the boat, and in the far distance, she could see a city. Great kings of the past had fashioned it, and had given their lives for it. But now the inhabitants were enthralled to a vast, lurking shadow. Stripped of their own will. The guardians blessed Raji, for she was the only hope for these people. Do I ask too much of her?
Time again will tell.
White peacock. What can it mean? What are those creatures that chase it?
The Garuda Gate.
But see, Rangda has the soldiers under her spell.
The fresh water at the gate? Greetings, little fly. Welcome to my lair.
Thank you.
the shrine to mighty Lord Vishnu. This must be Hiranyanagari. I have heard such tales of this place.
She recognizes the city built to your glory. Are you not pleased, O Vishnu?
It was my city, indeed. Built to house my temple. But it's no longer mine. A great shadow has fallen. Demons of Rangda, in my city?
Her shadow is long.
You must defeat them, Raji.
She cannot hear you, but she knows what to do.
See what they built in my name. A magnificent city, a prosperous city filled with marvels. Intricate carvings and intricate mechanisms. Mills powered by water, wheels that turn other wheels, that open gates and lift great weights.
Tell us, demons of water, mechanical slaves to Ranga. Careful, my Raji. Avoid their gaze.
The peacock, it cries out. Is it hurt?
Do you remember what I keep in my temple, Durga?
Of course. That gives her a chance. But the way is blocked. Look, the Gajan waters are high.
There are mechanisms to lower them. But what does she know of cocks and wings?
She is clever, this girl. She will find a way.
We have no mother, no father.
They are up there, in the stars, little brother.
Oh!
is a place of cunning. The mills, the water that feeds the green fields. There is no denying it is clever, Vishnu. It is such a concentration of power. And now it is Nirandar's hand.
Speak to me. Will you not wake up?
These people have no will. Their minds are clouded by Rangda's shadow. And so the city was taken without any way to fight back.
But they are alive, and so they can be freed. See here. It is the story of Garuda. There were two sisters, Kadru and Vinita, the most dear of wives of Maharshi Kashyap. He granted each a boon to show his affection. Kadru asked to become the mother of 1,000 sons. Vinita asked for just one son, but that he must be more powerful than the 1,000 sons of Kadru. Blessed by the Maharshi, Kadru gave birth to 1,000 eggs. Vinita gave birth to only 2 eggs. With time, Kadru's eggs began to hatch. Inside each one was a coiling snake. Vinita, impatient and jealous that her sister's eggs had already hatched, took it upon herself to break open one of her own eggs. Inside Vinita's egg was a half-formed bird-like creature. Enraged by his mother's actions, he cursed her, saying that she would be a slave to Kadru until her second egg hatched. And if she did not show patience with that hatching, she would forever be a slave. And so, under the curse of a half-formed offspring, and through the machinations of Kadru and her Naga children, Vinita became a slave to her sister. Years passed until one day Vinita's second egg finally hatched. From it emerged Garuda, the king of birds. Seeing his mother's servitude, Garuda asked the Nagas to free her. They agreed, but on the condition that Garuda would fly to heaven and fetch for them the elixir of immortality. Garuda, for his mother's sake, flew to the heaven of the Devas. He was too powerful for the Devas to defeat, and so seized the elixir from them.
I saw that Garuda did not want the elixir for himself, and so I manifested myself to him. Because his heart was pure, I granted him the gift of immortality. In return, he granted me the gift of becoming my mount, should I so desire it. I warned Garuda of the deceptive nature of the Nagas. So Garuda returned to the Nagas with the elixir, but tricked them, telling them that it could only be consumed after they had purified themselves in the holy river. He attacked them unsuspecting as they bathed and ate them up. He freed his mother, Vinita. For safekeeping, Brahma took the elixir and bore it back to the heavens. This is one of the mechanisms that will lower the Gargin waters. Is it too much for her?
Cogs and levers. This is no challenge compared to fighting demons.
Thank you.
water's dream.
It is not enough. There is more to do. Another garrison to fight.
She must hurry. We do not want Rangda to notice until Raji is prepared.
She must cleanse this, Durga. She must cleanse all of this.
She will. And perhaps the tree will grant her another vision of the future. What did this being want with Golu? To instruct him? To control him? Raji did not know what I knew. Here lay our greatest peril.
To think that there is fighting even in places of worship.
There is worship and fighting, if it is for the right cause.
This little fly has a sting. Who is this intruder, and why does she dare my wrath?
Lord Vishnu's temple.
Well done, Raji.
Maybe there I can find help.
The water spell? My poison dispelled. you will suffer for this, trespasser.
Thank you.
blessed Vishnu. I never thought to see such sights.
Maharaji, you will go further than this and see many more wonders before your time is done. I have no doubt.
She will also see terrors.
Indeed, this place is beautiful, but at its heart stands the usurper Rangda. I hope Raji is prepared.